We begin with a developing story. Two people are dead following a homicide in Albuquerque and a police standoff with the suspect. Action 7 News first told you this morning about the man shot and killed in his front yard in northeast Albuquerque.
And a few hours later, the search for the suspect moved two counties away. Action 7 News anchor Tanya Mendez joins us live from Hendola Drive with the latest on the investigation.
Doug, police tell us this is a case of a cheating wife and a husband scorned and seeking revenge. So he came to the house behind me and allegedly shot the man who was supposedly cheating with his wife and then took his wife and fled to Mora County. In this northeast Albuquerque front yard, crime scene tape and a man shot in cold blood. The search for a killer took police dozens of miles away. Sky 7 was there for the standoff lasting hours between Mora County deputies and state police and the suspected gunman, a husband who'd allegedly had it with his cheating wife.
We believe that this is a relationship situation gone bad. Husband killed the victim this morning, abducted her, was taking her to northern New Mexico.
Chief Ray Schultz says the wife was somehow able to escape and get to police, who went after the suspect, and a shootout ensued.
State police was able to intercept him, and there was some type of confrontation.
Back in Albuquerque, neighbors are still shaking.
I just felt that things were not quite right there, but I never could put a finger on it.
Gunfire was not the kind of alarm this father expected to hear while enjoying his last few minutes of sleep.
There was three sets of gunshots, and you could hear the whole time. It was just insane.
He ran outside just in time to see the taillights of a dark SUV screeching down the road, too worried about what he saw to show his face now.
Fear for my kids. And that was my first instinct.
And you can see Albuquerque police are still on the scene. At this point, there's no reason to think that there's any threat to this neighborhood because, again, the suspect in this case is confirmed dead. State police confirmed for us that he died. They've not told us the nature of his death, though, whether he died in that shootout with them or at his own hands or in some other way. Reporting live in northeast Albuquerque, I'm Tanya Mendez, KOAT Action 7 News.
State police have not yet released the name of the suspect because his family has not been known.